Let's see. I decoded it from binary and got a bunch of hex numbers. Knowing Uncle Chuck, he would have encrypted the will using the unbreakable exclusive ore and using his lucky number as the key. Okay, here goes. The rest of the bits are irrelevant to cryptography. I'll just bitwise and them away. I did it. I did it. It's totally decoded now. I'll give it back to Mr. Balowick.
Yes, Dolores? Do you have a question about your uncle's stipulations?
Here's a freshly baked thimbleberry pie.
One of Chuck's three stipulations is now fulfilled. We have a fresh thimbleberry pie. You still need to decode his will, and then we'll meet inside Chuck's opulent tomb.
Here's the decrypted will.
Let me see. You've done it, Dolores. Two of Chuck's three stipulations are now fulfilled. The final one is to read the will in your Uncle Chuck's opulent tomb. I'll meet you there.
Well, my family will wait right here until you've opened the tomb, Dolores. Hurry along. We don't have all evening. Poor Chucky needs his sleep.
Spotter, you're in the wrong spot. You want me to break my neck?
Be careful.
Okay, then. Here I go. Almost got the page. Almost got it. Got the page stuck back into the joke book. Got the page stuck back into the joke book. Got the page stuck back into the joke book. Got the page stuck back into the joke book. Ready to face my adoring public and win this contest already.
Thank you all for coming to witness the Ransom Lookalike Contest. We've got a great crowd here tonight.
What is he, blind?
Stinks in here.
Yes, well, it looks like we've got some great entries. And some not-so-great entries. But I'll be the judge of that. That's right, I'll be judging the contestants as they try to make us laugh. First up, we have Corey.
I have big hair.
He does! Oh my! That's funny!
Am I missing something here?
I'm Ransom, the jerk clown.
It's Ransom, the insult clown, you moron!
That's not a nice thing to say. You're all poo-poo heads. Just like Winnie the Pooh, you're sweet as a honey pot.
No way. You're all a bunch of inbred freaks. Don't try to deny it, because I've seen the sheriff, the coroner, and the hotel manager.
The sheriff, coroner, and hotel manager are all distinct people and awesome in their own right. You should be thanking them for keeping the town running.
You guys are obsessed with this Chuck guy. Seriously, I haven't seen brainwashing like this since the Manson family.
Don't you know it's disrespectful to speak of the dead that way? Especially the faultless Chuck Edmund.
I was amazed you aren't a bunch of fatzos.
Fatso? That's an incredibly hurtful and vulgar word to use. It's not something that any decent people say in public.
Bunch of ingrates.
Sounds like someone has to update their jokes. Now we have our final contestant, Corey.
What a lovely crowd we have tonight. I can't wait to meet all you wonderful special snowflakes.
This is so unbelievable.
Wasn't Chuck the best human? Don't you think?
Yes, and where's the punchline?
Punchline? What are you talking about? You're all silly billies, but you're still lovable.
Oh, kill me now.
This won't take long to decide the winner. In first place is, obviously, Corey!
Oh my! Thank you!
Corey wins a licensing deal with Mega Mega Toy Company.
I'm going to make a cute fuzzy dog!
But you could just walk into any toy store and buy that already!
Second place is Corey!
Of course it well is! Totally rigged!
How can anyone compete with Corey? It's a pleasure to come second to his first.
You've won a gift card for facial reconstruction surgery.
How exciting! Just like my hero, Michael Jackson.
Which leaves third and last place to... What was your name, anyway?
It's Ransom, you idiot.
Oh, your name is Ransom, too? That's an odd coincidence. Pity your act wasn't very convincing. So third place goes to the poorly named Ransom. You win an easy listening theremin record by Psykin. Congratulations to those who put some effort in.
It's a crappy recording of theremin music. Big whoop.
Shut up in there! Hoverboards will be mainstream by 2017. Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, that is a rare theremin song from Syken, a rad composer.
Hi! Anything I can interest you in? I'm selling comics, D&D manuals, and original Star Trek spec scripts. I also have a rare and priceless hint guide to a forgotten text adventure called Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2.
Can I trade you something for a hint guide?
What do you have to trade?
A kind smile?
Sorry, that's not worth trading for a Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2 hint guide. Bye!
Pew, pew.
I'm keeping it for someone special.
Hi! Anything I can interest you in? I'm selling comics, D&D manuals, and original Star Trek spec scripts. I also have a rare and priceless hint guide to a forgotten text adventure called Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2.
I have a level 7 wizard. Duck's a good D&D DM.
Okay.
I love Star Trek. I want to live on the Enterprise.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Hi! Anything I can interest you in? I'm selling comics, D&D manuals, and original Star Trek spec scripts. I also have a rare and priceless hint guide to a forgotten text adventure called Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2.
How much are the hint guides?
The Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2 hint guide is priceless. Just sell your soul and I'll give one to you.
If I thought selling my soul could solve the problem, I would have done it a long time ago.
It even contains a secret word that will crash your computer due to a bug in the code not caught by the testers.
Big deal. How about a trade for this stupid hint guide?
What do you have to trade?
A first edition ransom comic book?
Wow. A first edition Ransom the Clown comic? After his total meltdown, that's become a collector's item. You almost look like him. Except your costume is pretty crappy. I'll trade you the priceless Colossal Dungeon Cave Quest 2 hint guide for it.
What a ripoff.
Thanks.